Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Max.
Hello, everybody. This is Cecilia. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
So, what's been happening with you recently, Cecilia?
Just as usual, watching TV, dancing, nothing special. How about you?
Well, as you know, I've been reading a lot more recently, and I came across a nice news article about a family that adopted their kids.
It's nice to see that there are people who care about children without parents. 看多了这种娱乐圈乌烟瘴气的新闻啊，再看到这种还是很暖心的。那 adopt 就是指这种领养的行为，领养本身当然是好的了，但是呢，要在确定后续能给到被领养者足够的关爱这个前提之下，才能够叫负责任。
Well, in this case, they care a lot. Have a guess how many children they adopted.
I don't know, maybe 4, 6 at the very most.
Not even close. They adopted 30 kids.
30 children?That's quite a lot of children to be looking after. 这是要在自家办足球赛吗?
That's what I thought. But the parents love them all as if they were their own children. So, good for them, I guess.
I want kids, maybe 2 or 3, but 30, that's insane. I would die.
I can't even begin to imagine what raising children would be like. Can you?
Not at all. Even thinking about it, it's stressful.
Well, thankfully, this news article details what it's like to raise 30 children. So why don't we talk about adoption for today's topic?
Okay, sure.
So, I think I should make it clear. This family isn't a foster home. They are just a normal, well, if you can call having 30 kids normal, a normal family.
I see, so not a business.
No.So, a foster home is a place that takes in children because their parents abused them, or that there was a lack of care, while they are waiting for suitable people to adopt them.
就是那种专门抚养孤儿的家庭，寄养家庭哈。And what's the difference between a foster home and an orphanage? Orphanage 也是指孤儿院哈。那这种寄养家庭和孤儿院有什么区别呢?
Yeah, an orphanage is a place where children are taken care of,because their parents have either abandoned them, or sadly, their parents have died.
It's so sad. 就是说 orphanage, 这种孤儿院呢是照顾被父母抛弃或者父母去世的孩子的。那 foster home 是指被父母虐待或者忽视的孩子呢暂时寄养的地方。他们会在那里等待合适的家庭收养。抛弃、弃养我们用 abandon 这个词来表示。Well, I just don't get how people can abandon their kids.
I know, it's sad. Anyway, the article doesn't say where they adopted the kids from, but I imagine some are foster kids and some are orphans.
那不管是哪一种哈，能找到一个真正适合的归宿都是件好事。So, tell me more about the article.
Okay, so as we know, looking after 30 children is no simple task.Taking care of one kid can be quite difficult. Just think about the money that would cost.
Yeah. Actually, where do they get the money to be able to afford that?
Well, they happen to be in the USA, and the US government will give money to those who need it for childcare. This family receives $26,000 each month from the government, as well as other funds from their own family business.
Wow, that's over 170,000 RMB. What does all that money go on?
Well, think about it. Each month they spend $2,000 for minivans, $10,000 on medical care, and $15,000 to pay for 14 professional carers. And don't forget all the food and housing bill. That's a lot of money too.
Yeah, it really is. It must be more like a job for those parents.那这里提到了一个词叫做 carer， 它在英式英语里呢是指家庭护理员这种职业，也就是我们说的私人看护。
Yeah, a carer is someone who looks after people who are young, old, or sick.
Yeah, exactly. 他们的工作啊，主要就是照顾这些家居的老弱病患。
I think you're right about the parents. This must be their vocation.
Oh yeah, I agree. 这个 vocation 大家可千万别跟 vacation 弄混了哈。一个字母之差意思可差远了。
Yeah, a vocation is a type of work that you feel you are suited to doing and which you should give all your time and energy.
简单来说呢，就是指使命， 指一个人认为特别适合自己的工作或者说职业。But in this case, they aren't making any money from it.
Usually when people say they have a vocation, they don't care too much about making money. They just do what they do because they love to do it.
Right, right. 在这种使命感的驱使下,金钱报酬可能都没有那么重要了。So I could say teaching English is my vocation.
Sure. Everyone has a vocation, I think, but not everyone follows their vocation.
So do the kids know that their parents aren't their biological parents?这个 biological 是个形容词，它是指生物的，那加上 parents 就表示生物学上的父母，也就是亲生父母。那这是很多收养家庭都要面对的一个问题啊，要不要告诉孩子收养这个事实啊？对一些孩子来说，知道这件事可能会构成一种伤害，但是对另一些孩子来说呢，被隐瞒反而是另外一种伤害了。这个呢，就需要父母根据孩子的性格去衡量。
It didn't actually say, but I would think some of them would know that they aren't their real parents, as their age ranges from 5 to 25 years old.
Oh, right. So maybe the older ones would know. 我才意识到啊，在他们家应该也不存在说与不说这个选择，因为他们家有30个孩子，那可能孩子年纪大了，懂事了，自然就会意识到，这30个兄弟姐妹不可能全是父母生的哈。
Well, it's also a case of if they look anything like their parents.
Yeah, if you don't look anything like your parents, then maybe you can guess that they aren't your biological parents.
Right, they'll be your guardians. Guardians are people who have the legal right and responsibility to take care of someone who can't take care of themselves, such as children whose parents have sadly died.
讲到了 guardian 这个词，那 guard 做动词呢，表示守卫。加上表示人的这个词尾 ,ian, 构成名词 guardian, 就表示监护人。So, remember when you were a kid and your parents wanted to go away for a weekend?
Yeah, sure. My grandparents used to come and look after me.
So, do they become your guardians for the period of time when your parents are away?
Kind of, I guess. They were responsible for looking after me, but legally, my parents were still responsible for me, even if they were away.
Ah, so they become guardians because they need to look after you, but mom and dad are still legally responsible for you.
Yeah, exactly.
Fair enough. 那大家小时候应该都有过这种经历吧？父母有事外出，就把孩子交给亲戚朋友暂时看管一段时间。那这种时候呢，亲戚朋友就成了你的临时监护人。
Anyway, I think it's great that those two people have taken in so many kids. It's very hard to find people who want to adopt one child, never mind 30.
Yeah, I feel happy for those kids. It's nice to find a family where they feel accepted and the sense of belonging. Though I still find it quite unbelievable.
You're telling me. I think that's all the time we have for today.
Hello, welcome to Morning English.早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So, thank you very much for listening. This is Max.
This is Cecilia. See you next time. Bye. Bye.